Hey there, how was doing? This is Kali from Techfanciers. Here we are taking an in-depth look on latest official Descendant OS 3.0 GSI on ASUS Zenfone Lite L1. And this one works in all the devices which is supports Project Treble. Also, this one is from Phhusson's Treble project. And to be clear, whatever bugs I am mentioning is only for this device, not for all the one out there. The compatibility differs from device to device. And this one is currently running on Android Pie and June 5th security patch on 2GB RAM and Snapdragon 430 Octo core processor. That's pretty much for the start. So, welcome to the series of in-depth look, episode number 18. Roll the intro. First is first, the boot animation. It's good, simple, the logo of Descendant D and finally showing the name, everything is perfect and minimalistic. The first boot and first day with the build is not so impressive. After a day, the things got better. Initial, there are lot of glitches and force stops, now it's fine. In this review, I will be mostly comparing this one with the .OS and default stock OS, which is ZenUI. First cool thing about this build is the status bar. Unlike normal Android Pie, this one has the different UI and experience. The brightness slider is different and also there is a text to show the end of the battery. I guess this one of the feature of latest Android Q. Also in the lock screen you can set the time as text. This one to Android Q feature. These things are really appreciable and the volume toggle, unlike the .OS, you can access the entire volume control, not only for the media. Also there is a toggle to put it into silent, vibrate on general, useful one in my opinion. Also I have turned off the QoS style titles, so this status bar looks minimal and great. And there is one UI customization in display where you can change the corner to roundier, not round. It's awesome. And if you are coming straight from stock OS, this one feels little smooth and fluid. The reason is timing and duration of the animation. It's well designed. Appearance wise, one of the coolest ROM that I ever seen, period. I liked it a lot and enjoy the new experience with this. Features wise, it brought some new features like thumb UI, which lets you to use or access the settings using your thumb. But it's in beta stage, makes some glitches, but they tried to bring this one like which present in the One UI on Samsung. Full gesture mode allows you to hide all the buttons in the navbar other than the main rounded key. Those are some features which I kinda look like and feel cool. Also, I wanted to talk little about the digital well-being, which is one of the user-friendly feature where you can control the usage time and restrict the phone usage. I thought to mention this one on my .OS video, but yes, I'm using this feature and turned on for all the day. The device get grayish color after 12 at night automatically. And there are some changes in default apps. There is no AOSP gallery, camera or browser. They have merged with third party apps like Open Camera for camera, Phonography for music, Amaze for file manager, Camera Roll for gallery, Kiwi for browser. I personally use Open Camera to shoot videos and Gcam for to take pictures. Phonography is really the great music player. These things are major advantage of Descendant and made the build unique one. Well, let's talk about demerits of this OS. There is no auto brightness support like all HS GSI on this device. So every time need to change it manually. The battery backup is not the best. I can't show you the exact report and screen on time as it is not working as expected. Roughly it is coming 430 hours to 5 hours of screen on time, but not the worst. It long lasts the day with minimal usage. Volume level is low like .OS. I have installed Dolby Digital Plus, but still need improvements. Somewhere the random glitches and force stopping is happening. That's one of the drawback of this OS. And I have to mention that the hotspot is turning off after some point of time. Sometimes it's not happening, sometimes it's happening. working fine otherwise. RAM management is not so good, it's like stock OS only. 3 apps you can run at the time, more than that it will kill. I am looking for solution to fix the RAM management issue on our device. We'll make one video on it soon. Also, the ASUS devices nowadays having this issue, even in Zenfone Max Pro M1 having this killing app thing. So we need to consider and look for the solution. Also, I am not big fan of quick step launcher. If we uninstall also, the quick reset won't work. The reason why I don't like this one is whenever I try to open the app drawer, it shows the reasons. That's annoying. Earlier I was using CPL launcher in .os, but here the reasons are not showing up in CPL, so I get to use quick step only. I really appreciate the default camera app is open camera, but after enabling camera to API and installing Gcam on this OS, the open camera not working on front camera. It's showing some other camera app using it, so that's kind of an issue to face. But in that OS, both are working in simultaneously. These are some of the issues that I faced after installing Descendant 3.0. Well, the result, you can use it as a daily driver if you want. There is no critical issue with the ROM. At least it's worth taking a look at least once. It's really wonderful and fluid for eyes. Yeah, as per the poll results, we will be switching to Havok OS. I have never tried Havok OS and I really excited to do that, to know about that. Right now I am switching it. Let me know your thoughts about this video. If you liked my work, leave a like if you like this work, and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Thank you for watching. I will see you guys in my next good one. Code Moto.